गुड मॉर्निंग सर गुड मॉर्निंग। माय वॉइस इज ऑडिबल टू ऑल ऑफ यू?
यस सर।
ओके भवानी सर, वी विल स्टार्ट।
यस सर, स्टार्ट करो।
टिल नाउ 29 हैव जॉइंड, सो यस्टरडे 40 हैव जॉइंड। So I think we will wait 2 minutes, 2 to 3 minutes. Otherwise, we will start as whatever you will tell.
Okay, sir. How many minutes of back or jan?
Because 40 out of 40 till now, apart you and me, 31 minutes, 29 joined.
Again. Okay, sir. 2 minutes rahi jan do. Start kar do.
Yes.
सर आप स्टार्ट कर वेटिंग रूम एनेबल कर दे जी आसवे से जॉइन कर।
सो गाइस वी विल स्टार्ट। यस्टरडे वी हैड स्टडीड अबाउट पाइथन इंट्रोडक्शन एंड सम बेसिक टर्मिनोलॉजी दैट वी आर डिस्कसिंग। सो वेरिएबल एंड डेटा टाइप, this basic terminology that we have completed. Today we will go to a new chapter, that is Python operators. So Python operators, one of the fundamental terminology, but it is important. The importance of operator is very crucial. So we will see what is an operator, how Python or how many operators Python is supporting. So we will cover in detail. This is all about today's agenda. So basically, an operator is a symbol which performs an operation. An operator act often which data items is known as operands. For example, suppose I will write 5 + 3 = 8. Just to see, plus is a symbol, that plus representing it is an operator. This plus operator acting often the data item 5 and 3. So we can say 5 is operand. So this is operator. So this is operator. And 5 and 3. So this is operand. This is operand. Okay. So now we will see many operators Python supports 8 operators. Okay, many operators which are as follows. So we will see one by one. So first is Python arithmetic operators. So now I will go to my Jupyter notebook environment. So Python arithmetic operators. So one point you remember, hash symbol. So that representing comment line. Okay. So every comment line having no effect. So that comment line cannot execute by the control. Simply that line will help us make a comment line representing what you have done. Okay. So that's why in Python programming, if any line you are writing and your line preceded by the hash symbol, so we can consider that is a comment line. So Python arithmetic operators, addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, just to see if you are not remembering, then you can write your note. Everything, I hope everybody is writing. So make a note, okay? And when we will complete Python programming, and your note will be a beautiful note, and that note will give sufficient knowledge about Python. So single slash, we can say it is a division operator. Double slash is also division operator. I will show you what is the difference. Then percentage symbol, this is called as modulo, M-O-D-U-L-O. So you write in your note. So addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, again division, modulo, then to the power. Double star symbol, that is called as to the power. Okay. Everybody getting clarity? Give a response. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So
yes, sir.
We will consider two example. Let we have a variable. Suppose let the variable x, the value of x is 5, and we considered another variable. Let the value of y equals to suppose 3. Now we considered two variables x and y. The value 5 is assigning to x. The value 3 is assigning to y. Just you tell what is the value of x plus y. 5 plus 3, that is 8. X minus y, 5 minus 3, that is 2. X into 3, 5 into 3, that is 15. X divided by y. Single slash, you remember, single slash meant for floating value, float value. Whereas double slash revision meant for decimal value. So normal division, suppose I will divide 5 by 3. So 3, 5 minus 3, that is 2. Then I will put a point, then 0, then 6. So normal division, 1.6666 something. So you remember single slash, definitely the output value is a floating value. Just to see, I will hit run, just to see normal division 1. This. But double slash, x divided by y, double slash meant for decimal value, this is your what? This quotient value. Suppose 5 by 3. So 3, 5. This is the output. Okay. There is no floating concept. Quotient value. 5 divided by 3. So that is 1. So there is no decimal. There is no floating concept. Okay. 5 by 3, if your division operator is double slash, basically that is called as floor division. Okay, so that is your quotient value, that is output is 1. So similarly, x modulo y, modulo means a remainder of value. You see, so modulo means a remainder of value. This is the modulo output, that is 2. So 5 modulo 3, output will be 2. Now you see, I will hit run. So you get 2. So x to the power y, 5 to the power 3. That is 5 into 5 into 5. So 5 to the power 3, 125. So clear. I hope everybody got clarity. Give a response. Addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, again division, that is floor division, double slash, and to the power. Then we will go to the next operator. Next operator is Python comparison operator. Python comparison operators. Comparison. So what are the Python comparison operators? Less than equals to, greater than equals to, double equals to, and not equals to. So these are the comparison operators. Less than equals to, greater than equals to, double equals to, then not equals to. Here in this context, means in comparison operator context, in this context, the output value must be a Boolean value. A Boolean value, remember, either it will be true or it will be false. Okay, so in comparison operator context, the output value is a Boolean value, whether it will be true or false. Suppose I will write x is less than y, that means 5 is less than 3. So true or false? So it will be true or false based on the expression. Our expression is x is less than y. Guys, you tell, 5 is less than 3. True or false?
False.
Yes, so when I will hit run, so I will get false. Similarly, you tell x is less than equals to y. You tell, so true or false? X is less than equals to y. True or false? Very simple question. False. 5 is less than equals to 3, that is false. Similarly, x is greater than y. 5 is greater than y, that is true. 5 is greater than equals to 3, that is true. Similarly, you tell x double equals to y. 5 double equals to 3. True or false?
False.
5 double equals to 3, that is false. X is not equal to y. 5 is not equals to 3. True or false?
True.
5 is not equals to 3. Yes. 5 equals to 5. 5 is not equals to 3. That is true. So now I will hit run. This I got it true. So this is all about comparison operators. Okay. So in this way, Python supporting 7 operators. So one operator, I completed arithmetic operators. So second operator we completed, that is comparison operators. So in comparison operator context, we are getting the output value, that is true or false, Boolean value. Then we will move forward. We will go to the next operator, Python logical operators. Python logical operators. So logical AND operator, logical OR operator, and logical NOT operator. So actually this concept is a digital electronics concept. I think you all have known, I think. So directly there is a formula for logical AND, logical OR, logical NOT, logical AND true, output is true, then false, output is false, true, output is false. Then false, false, output is false. This is logical AND formula. So two expression we will evaluate whether we will get true or false. In logical operator context, the output value also be a Boolean value, whether it will be true or it will be false. So in logical AND, the formula is true, 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 and all are false. Similarly, in case of a logical OR, so true, true, output is true, true, false, output is true, false, true, output is true, false, false, output is false. In logical OR, the true, 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 and all are, false, 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 and all are true. In later on, there is another formula XOR. Logical AND, logical OR, and logical XOR. True, true, output is false. Then false, true, output is true. Then true, false, output is true. Then false, false, output is false. You remember and you write. This is the formula of logical AND, logical OR, and logical XOR. Logical AND, logical OR, and logical XOR. Okay, so accordingly, we will see. Okay, now we will come to our environment. I hope everybody is writing this formula. You write this formula, you write. Give a response.
Yes, sir.
Then we will go to our environment. So suppose I will write, suppose x plus y, let it is greater than equals to y, and x is equals to y, suppose. Okay, so now just you see, this is expression one and this is expression two. First of all, we will evaluate expression one. So expression one, you tell either we are getting it true or false. You tell, guys, you give the answer.
True.
You see, 5 plus 3, that is 8. 8 is greater than equals to 3. True. Then come to expression. You tell. So 5 is not equals to 3. That is true. So true and true. So in AND operation, true, true, output is true. So overall, output is true. Now I will hit on how I got. Okay. So give a response. So first expression, then second expression, I evaluated and I got the true. Suppose I will write x plus y is less than y, or x is not equals to y. Okay, then you tell what will be the output. So similarly, this is expression one, this is expression two. Okay, then just you evaluate x plus y, 5 plus 3, that is 8. 8 is less than y. Y is 3. 8 is less than 3, that is false. Then you come to second expression, x is not equals to, x is not equals to y. That is true. So false, false, or true. So we will see. So in OR operator, false, true, this false, true, true. So output will be true. Now I will hit run. I will get it. So give a response. I hope everybody got clarity. Give a response.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay. Suppose I will write x and y. Then who will tell what is the output? X and y. X means the value of x. Y means the value of y. So value of x is 5. 5 is a constant value. Y means the value of y. Value of y is 3. 3 is a constant value. 5 and 3. So it is not an expression. But in other programming language, I mean in Java programming, it is error. But in Python programming, you remember x and y, the output is the value of y, that is 3, not 0 and 1. I'm sorry, not true and false. Because how the control is understanding, x1 memory is allocating, memory name is x, value is 5. And y, so the value of y is overridden over that memory. So as a result, the output value, that is y value. And x or y, overall, in general, you remember constant and constant, second operand value, constant or constant, first operand value is output. So here, x or y, output is 5, the value of x. Okay, so overall, you remember, in Python programming, only these two cases exceptional. Apart these two cases, otherwise output will be a Boolean value, whether it will be true or false. Okay, so constant and constant, operand two value is output, constant or constant, first operand value is output. Clear? Give a response. Give a response.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now we will go to NOT operator. Just to see, NOT true, that is false. NOT false, that is true. Suppose I will write x plus y is less than y. Okay. So 5 plus 3, 8. 8 is less than 3. That is false. But if I will write NOT this expression, okay, so not one expression, first of all, you evaluate that expression. So I evaluated and I got false. Not false, that is true. Now I will hit run. So I got clear. So this is all about, this is all about Python logical operators. So in this way, three operators we completed: arithmetic operators, comparison operators, and logical operators. Logical and, logical or, and logical not. So then we will go to the next operator, Python assignment.
Excuse
operator.
Me, sir.
Ah, yes, yes.
Sir, instead yes. of and, or, and not, we can use the symbol of and, or, and not.
No. This is inbuilt. Whatever the developer Guido van Rossum and its team, whatever the Python software foundation, they have given the term. So and in word, so symbol that is coming, that whatever you are telling, that is coming another, that point is coming in the form of another operator, bitwise operators. We will go to that point. Okay, so this is okay, logical sir. And in word I have written logical and, logical or, logical not. Okay, so then Python assignment operator means equals to. But you remember single equals to, that is called as assignment operator. But double equals to, that is called as a comparison operator that we studied. Suppose I will write x1 equals to 200. That means x1 is a variable name, the value 200 assigning to x1. So what is the value of x1? Now I will run, so 200. Okay, so equals operator, that is called as assignment operator. Now I will write x1 plus equals to 50. So what do you mean by plus equals to, minus equals to, into equals to, division equals to, okay, to modulo equals to the power equals to. That means one point you remember, any arithmetic operator including assignment operator is known as, you remember, that is compound assignment operator. That is compound assignment operator. Okay, so we have written x1 plus equals to 50. That means x1 equals to x1 plus 50. That means 200 plus 50. That means 250. Okay, so plus equals to any arithmetic operator, including assignment operator, that is known as compound assignment operator. Okay, so x1 plus equals to 50 means x1 plus 50, that means 200 plus 50, that is 250. So now I will hit run. So what is the value of x1? So that is 250. Here give a response, assignment operator, and this is called as compound assignment operator. Plus equals to, that is called as compound assignment operator. Compound assignment operator. Okay, Bhavani sir.
Yes, sir.
Bhavani sir.
Yes, sir.
Sir, after this class, so whatever in this environment I am writing, so that okay. Note also I will send to your mail. So please, okay. You ask what post in our group.
Okay, sir.
So enter this PDF file. I will send to your mail. So you can send in the group. So as a result, whatever I am writing, if anybody can do the practice in practically, so some error if somebody will face, so they can take the help from this note.
Okay, sir. Okay.
So then we will go to the next operator. So after Python assignment operator, we will go to Python bitwise operators. Bitwise operators. Okay. So Python bitwise operators. So bitwise AND. Now somebody was asking symbol. Now this symbol. Bitwise AND. Bitwise OR. Bitwise OR. Bitwise XOR. Bitwise NOT. Left shift or right shift. Just I will write in word. Maybe you will forget. So Python bitwise operators. Python bitwise operators. First is bitwise AND. Bitwise AND. Bitwise OR. Bitwise OR. Bitwise XOR. Bitwise XOR. Then bitwise NOT. Bitwise NOT operator. Then left shift operator. And then right shift operator. Okay, so what do you mean by bit? Basically, so I hope you have known. I think basically bit means 0 and 1. Okay. So basically bit means 0 and 1. Basically we say binary form. Okay, so you remember guys one point, every input value, suppose I am inputting 5. 5 is converting into 8 number of bit. You remember, so when the machine is understanding every input value as 8 number of bits, That means 8 number of 0 and 1. To remember this point, suppose my test case already we have x equals to 5, y equals to 3. Suppose I will find out what is the value of x and y, what is the value of x or y, what is the value of x or y, what is the value of bitwise not x. So how I will evaluate? So x is 5, y is 3. So now I will convert 5. 5 is the decimal number. 5 is the decimal number. So how decimal number is converting? How decimal number is converting into binary form? That means 0 and 1. Simply, I hope you have known, it is a purely digital electronic subject. Okay. So decimal into binary. So binary means 0 and 1 basically. We say that is a bit. So how 5 is converting into 8 number of bits? The concept is saying you divided by 2. You divided by 2. Only you number whatever you have, the decimal value you divided by 2. So first 2, if I will divide it, then I will get remainder. So that is 1. So I got 1. Then again I will divide it by 2. It will continue. So again I will divide it by 2. Then I will get this is 1. And so remainder is 0. So now 1 is not divided by 2. When the value is not able to divide it by 2, you will stop. Now you will count in this way. Just you see in which way I am going. So in which way I am representing my cursor. How I presented arrow mark. So 5 binary form is 101. Okay, simply whatever you have the decimal value, just you will divide it by 2. And remainder value, we just you will consider. And it will continue. Okay, so when the value is not able to divide it by 2, at that moment you will stop. Then you will count in this way. So 5, so I can write 5. So 5, so binary form is 101. So then eight number of bits, all are 0101. So before 3 digit, all remaining 5, I will put 0. First give a response. Everybody got clarity or not?
Yes, sir.
5 is converting into 8 number of bits. Similarly, so we will convert 3. So just you see what is the 3 binary form. Just I will divide it by 2. So 2 into 1, then remainder is 1. So 3 by 2. So 2 into 1, that is 2. Then remainder is 1. So now 1 is not able to divide it by 2. So output is 1, 1. Okay. So 3 binary form. 3 binary form is 11, then I will remaining 0. Okay, so now this is the 5 binary form and this is the 3 binary form. So now I will perform AND operation. Okay, so now here when you will convert decimal value into binary form means into bits 0 and 1. Now, in this context, 0 will be for. After converting into 0 and 1, in this context, 0 meant for false, 1 meant for true. Okay, so just to see, now we will perform AND operation. So 1 means true, 1 and 1, 1 and 1, that means true and true. So already in logical and true and true, 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 true. That is one. Okay. So once decimal value you converted into bit means zero and one means binary form, then zero means false, one means true. So now our task is we will perform AND operation. So one and one, that means true and true. So I will get the output that is true. That means one. Similarly, one and zero, because logical AND already we have studied. So here one and zero, that is zero. Zero and one, that is zero. Zero and zero, that is zero. So all are zero, means false. So we got, so I performed, so I performed AND operation, we got output value that is one, but it is in binary form. Okay, so this is binary form. Now this binary form I will convert into decimal form, and that will be the our desired output. So how binary form I will convert into decimal? So 1 into 2 to the power 0. 1 into 2 to the power 0, that is 1. Something to the power 0, that is 1. So this is the decimal form. So now this is the desired output. So x and y, so output is x and y, output is 1. Similarly, you tell OR operation. Now I will perform OR operation. 1 or 1. First is 1, 1. 1 or 1. That is 1. Logical OR operator already we studied. Similarly, 1 or 0. 1 means true. 0 means false. True or false. That is true. Similarly, 0 or 1 means false or true. That is true in logical OR. True, 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 false, true, false, true, true, false, false, false. Then 0 or 0, 0, 0 or 0, 0, all are 0. So in logical OR, in logical OR, in logical OR, this is logical AND. This is logical AND. So I got a binary form 1, 1, 1. So now this binary form I will convert into decimal. So in this way, I will convert. When decimal to binary, dividing by 2. When binary to decimal, I am multiplying into 2 to the power, some 0, 2 to the power 1. Just to see, 1, I will write 1 into 2 to the power 0 plus 1 into, plus 1 into, 1 into 2 to the power 1 plus 1 into 2 to the power 2. Plus 1 into 2 to the power 1 plus 1 into 2 to the power 2. So in this way, a binary form I will convert into decimal. So just to see, 1 into 2 to the power 0, that is 1. Plus 1 into 2 to the power 1, that is 2. Then plus 1 into 2 to the power 2, that is 4. So 1 plus 2, that is 3. 3 plus 4, that is 7. So this is the decimal form and this is the output. So x or y output is 7. Give a response. X or y output is 7. So x or y, first I converted x into x value into 8 number of bit, y value I converted into 8 number of bit, then I performed OR operation, I got triple 1. Then now triple 1 is binary form. So whatever I got the binary form value, again I converted into decimal form. So that decimal value is our desired output value. So give a response. Yes, I hope everybody got clarity.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Everybody is writing. Everybody is writing,
yes,
or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
And similarly, you tell x or y, x or 1, x or 1. That means true, x or true, that is 0. True, x or true, that is 0. Then 1 means true, x or 0 means false. True, x or false, that is 1. then false 0 XOR 1, that means false XOR 1, that is 1. Because in XOR already I have written, so true, true, false, 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 true, false, true, false, true, true. Now this is the XOR expression. This is the XOR expression. I got 1, 1, 0. So now this binary I will convert into decimal. So decimal value will be 6. You will count. So decimal value will be 6. Just you see 0 into 2 to the power 0 plus 1 into 2 to the power 1 plus 1 into 2 to the power 2. So that is 6. 0 into 2 to the power 0, that is 0, plus 1 plus 1 into 2 to the power 1, that is 2, 0 plus 2 plus 4, that is 6. So x, x or y, that is 6. So you write. So in this way that we found, so ax bitwise and output is 1, ax bitwise or y output is 7, then ax x or y output is 6. You write. Rasmi. Rasmi. Okay, so you write. Give a response. Everybody is writing.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now we will
yes,
see.
Sir.
So we will see in our environment. Santosh. Santosh. Rasmi. X. B2Y's and Y. Now I will hit run. We will get the output, that is 1. X, then B2Y's or then Y. Just to see what I have got, X or Y, I have got 7. Now I will hit run. I will get 7. X, X or Y, just to see X, X or Y, I have got 6. Then I will hit run, output is 6. Clear? So in which way that we found, so in that way also our Python control evaluated and Python control provided the output 1, 7 and 6. Now, bitwise not x, bitwise not x. Now you see, so what is the value, binary form of x, x value 5, 1, 0, 1. 101. You remember, in case of bitwise not, in case of bitwise not, your input value plus 1. Your input value plus 1. Again, I'm saying, in case of bitwise not operator, in case of bitwise not operator, your input value plus 1. So binary arithmetic, is what? 0 plus 1 equals to 1. 0 plus 1 equals to 1. Then 1 plus 0 equals to 1. Then 1 plus 1 equals to 1, 0. Okay. 1 plus 1 equals not equals 2. In a binary arithmetic, only 0 and 1. So 1 plus 1 equals to 1, 0. So just to see, you add now our input value is 1, 0, 1 plus 1. Just to see, 1 plus 1. 1 plus 1, that is 1, 0. Now I will put 0 here. Then I will put 1 here. I will take 1 outside. Now this 1. This 1 plus 0, that is 1, and this is 1. So 1, 0, 1 plus 1 equals to 1, 1, 0. So this is a binary form. So what is the decimal? 1, 1, 0 is 6. So not x, bitwise not x equals to, so whatever you will get the output, that is 6, before that you put the minor symbol. You remember, this is a protocol. This is a protocol in case of B2Y is not operator. In case of B2Y is not operator, output value must be a negative value, minus signed value. First of all, what you will evaluate, so what the output value is coming to your picture, then minus that value. Just to see in Jupyter notebook environment, I will write B2Y is not X. Now I will hit run, I got minus X. Clear? Give a response. I hope everybody got clarity.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this part everybody have written. I will move forward. Means I will go to a new file. Everybody writing. So everybody have written all these things. Yes.
Sir.
Yes, you ask.
Sir, B2Y is not a or ek baar samjha dijiye.
B2Y is not means. B2Y is not X. X value is 5. So your input value, X value is 5, that is 101. 5 binary form is 101. So B2Y is not means your input value plus 1. Your input value plus 1. So 5 binary form is 101 plus 1. Now I added, I got 110. 1 plus 1, that is 10. Here I will put 0 and I will take 1 to the outside. Now this out 1 plus 0, that is 1. Then 1 normal addition, in which way that you are adding normally. So in that way, just I added 101 plus 1, then I got 110. So 110, I got, this is a binary form. Now I converted into decimal. 110 decimal is 6. So output is minus 6. B2Y is not operator. Your output value preceded by minus sign. Clear? Clear? Give a response.
Yes, sir.
Okay, everybody have written. I will go to the new file. For left shift and right shift. So left shift and right shift, there is a direct formula. Left shift, this is left shift. Left shift direct formula, your input value, direct formula, input value into 2 to the power, into 2 to the power number of shifting values. Number of shifting value. So this is the left shift formula and right shift formula. Your input value divided by 2 to the power number of shifting values. So this is the direct formula. Your right shift operator, input value divided by 2 to the power number of shifting value. For example, suppose I will write x left shift 3. So that means the value of x is 5. Left shift 3 means number of shifting value, that is 3. So x value is 5 into number of shifting value is 3. That means 5 into 2 to the power 3. 2 to the power 3, that is 8, equal, that is 40. So output is 40. Similarly, if I will write x right shift 2, so means the value of x is 5, so right shift operator, so 2 means number of shifting value, that is 2. So value of x is 5 by 2 to the power 2. 2 to the power 2, that is 4. 5 by 4, that is 5 divided 4, that is 1, because quotient left shift 3, that is 40. We will see in our Jupyter notebook environment. Now I will hit run, I got 40. X right shift 2, I will hit run, I got 1. Okay, so this is all about bitwise operators. Python bitwise operator, in this way 5 operators we completed: arithmetic operators, comparison operators, logical operators, assignment operators, bitwise operators, five operators we completed. So from the beginning I have told there are seven operators, then we have remaining two operators. So now I will go to next operator, Python identity operators. Python identity operators, that is not. So two operator, Python identity operators. One is operator, another is not operator. Here, in this context, the output value must be a Boolean value. That is, it will be true or false. Okay, just you see, suppose I will write a variable, suppose x2 equals to 100, y2 equals to 100. Suppose two variable I considered x2 and y2. The value 100 assigning into x2, the value 100 assigning into y2. Similarly, I have a list. Just after collection, we will go to, after this operator chapter, we will go to the next chapter, collection chapter. Collection chapter, we will cover list, just little bit information. A list identified square bracket, or you can say within square bracket, we can consider a group of data items. Suppose I will write 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, suppose. It is a list, a group of data items. When we assigned within a square bracket, that representing list. Let the list name is x3 and y3, same data item 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, suppose. Now I will hit run. So this is my input. Let x2, y2 is two variable whose value is 100. Let x3 and y3 to list whose value is 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. Now I will write x2 is y2. Okay, so x2 is y2. x2 means the value of x2, y2 means the value of y2. So 100 is 100. Yes, so that is true. Now I will hit run true. Now I will write x3 is y3. Then you tell the answer. What is the answer, you guys? So you tell what is the answer, true or false?
True.
Okay, so answer, give the answer, true or false? Any guess? True? No. Okay, everybody will tell it is true, but output will be false. Everybody will say, sir, output, how it will be false? Just you see, now I will hit run. So I got false. So how it is false? Just you see, X3 is a list. How the control is understanding, that is the most important point that we have to analyze. List is a memory. Suppose, later on again, I will, regarding this context, I will give the clarity. Suppose you consider there is a one petty biscuit. So lots of or varieties of collections of biscuit are available, but from outside, when we will see, that is one petty. That means a group of data items assigned in a memory. Internally, a memory is creating, name of the memory is X3 or name of the memory is Y3, that memory containing group of data items. But when X3 is Y3, how the control is understanding? Because memory one, suppose you consider in real time scenario, one biscuit patty, suppose you have another biscuit patty you have. So how you will compare that one first biscuit patty with another biscuit patty? Because how you will compare, if you will open that patty, then you can compare. Maybe inside the patty, same biscuit may available. But overall collection means a single name. But inside the single memory, a group of data items. Content may be equal. But I have to go through, or I have to enter into that collection. previously x2 is a variable means contains one value, then control is understanding, okay, x2 means 100, y2 means 100, but x3 is y3. If each data item, first data item of x3, first data item of y3, it will compare. Then second data item of x3, second data item of y3, it should compare. But this is not the logic. Each operator or using each operator, individual or all content of x3 and all content of y3 is not comparing. So if you will compare, for that we will write another logic. So here what the control will do, control saw x3 is a petty, y3 is another petty. Maybe that petty, two petty contains same content. Then how the control understood, control compared to where is the address value. X3 means the address of x3, particularly in your context, and y3 means the address of y3. So when this task provided to control, so control particularly in each operator, control, what the control did, control is comparing x3 address value, y3 address value. So two address value never equal. Your address and my address never equal. Maybe in your house, whatever you have a particular TV, in my rooms, particular TV I have, content may be equal, but address to address value never equal. I hope everybody got clarity. So that's why control provided false value. X3 is Y3, that means the value, address value of X3, because X3 is nothing but a named memory. Y3 is nothing but a named memory. Internally, a memory is allocating that memory containing group of data items. Y3 means internally, a memory is allocating a group of, it is containing a group of data items. But X3 is Y3, means one petty is comparing with another petty. But if I will enter into the petty and if I will open another petty, then I can compare. Okay, give a response. Why x3 is y3, the control returning false value. Give a response. I hope everybody got clarity. Give a response. So if you will write x3 is not y3, x3 is not y3, now it is true. Okay, so this is all about identity operators. Is or and is not. Is then is not. Two operator calling as identity operators. So it is returning a Boolean value whether it will be true or false. So in this way, six operators we completed. Then we will go to the last operator, Python membership operators. Python membership operators, one is in, another is not in. So this is membership operators, very simple like identity operators. It is also returning a Boolean value whether it will be true or false. Suppose I will write hello world. Suppose s is a variable, the value of s is hello world. Suppose I will write age in s. So true or false. So in Python, there is no character concept. Everything is a string. Now age I identified by a single quote. So you tell age is available in S or not. S means hello world. S means the value of S is hello world. Then guys, you tell true or false. The character H available in hello world or not. Guys, you tell. So true or false?
False.
So why false?
Sir, because it is small letters.
Okay, yes, right answer, because lowercase h not available, programming is case sensitive. There is a difference between uppercase character and lowercase character. So that's why it will return false. So if I will write h not in s, then it will be true. Otherwise, if I will write h in s, it will return true. Clear? Okay, so this is all about operators. So in this way, we completed seven operators. Okay, in this way, we completed seven operators. So Python supporting seven types of operators: arithmetic operator, then what? Comparison operator, then logical operator, then assignment operator, then bitwise operator, then identity operator, then membership operators. So this is today's session. Now I will send the entire document to your mail. So this document I am sending, so to Bhavani sir, then Bhavani sir will give Bhavani sir.
Yes sir.
So I am sending to you this file. So please you post this file in group. So as okay, a sir. Result, everybody can get the note also simultaneously. Everything. So we are providing the lecture, then simultaneously we are providing the notes, and simultaneously you are recording. So for content everybody is getting. So I hope within 1 month everybody will export. Any question from your side,
sir? ସେମାନଙ୍କର ଅପରେଟର ଲଜିକାଲ ଅପରେଟର ସବୁ ଥିଲା ବଟ ତାଙ୍କ ସିଲାବସରେ ବହୁତ କମ ଥିଲା ଆଉ ଟିକେ ଅଧିକା ବ୍ରିଫ ହେଇଯିବେ ଏବେ ଆଉ
ସୋ ଟୁଡେ ଟୁଡେ ଏଭ୍ରିବଡି ନ୍ୟୁ ସୋ ରିମେନିଂ ଅପରେଟର୍ସ ଓକେ ସୋ ଦେର ଆର ଦିସ ଅପରେଟର୍ସ ସୋ ଆକ୍ଚୁଆଲି ଭବନେଶ ସାର୍ ମାଇ ପଏଣ୍ଟ ଇଜ ଷ୍ଟୁଡେଣ୍ଟ ଏଭ୍ରିବଡି ଶୁଡ୍ ପ୍ରିପେୟାର ରିଗାର୍ଡିଂ ଜବ୍ କଣ୍ଟେକ୍ସଟ ଓକେ ହ୍ୱାଟ ଏଭର ଦ ସିଲାବସ ଓକେ ଦ୍ୟାଟ ଇଜ ଓକେ ସୋ ଦେ ୱିଲ୍ ଲର୍ନ And if they will prepare what based on the job, so definitely that will what help to them, and they will be acquainted accordingly.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So thank you to all of you. And any question you ask, otherwise I will wind off my session.
Sir, कौन पचार रहा है जी? सर बात कर पचार दियो.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, actually, kali Anaconda software install कर ली. Then Jupyter then launch for the launch only sir.
One thing that you do so in next class, I think otherwise one thing you can do, you see the video otherwise.
Yes,
do you know any desk? Yes.
हाँ sir, एडम मुकर दे मुतास तो कथा है कि ताऊ कर दे इसका sort
of. Okay.
प्रकार कौन डालता है? अजित, yes अजित.
सर जोड़ी जो हमर थिला x एंड y 3 सर तार तो स्पेस सर जति हमें नउजन 2 2 बाय नउजन समान रहउ तार वैल्यू भी सर समान तो कोन पे फॉल्स हो
योर वॉइस इज स्प्लिटिंग एक्चुअली आई एम नॉट लिसनिंग वेल सो अगेन अगेन ठीक है क्लियरली को यस
सर x3 and y3 value is are same and sari din au jodi tako pattern only 2 2 bit sari nau jodi tal sare ethi kon pa false
actually most jani
pon mo mate mate is first aso bol voice so bol thik ache
ajit thoda kaam ho gaya breaking actually
ajit e jo note ta author dekhibo plus sar kar jo video ta mu debi seta bi author check karbo jodi kichi doubt hobo tale kali author pachare thik ache
ନା ଭବାନୀ ସାର୍ ପଚାରନ୍ତୁ ଆଉ ଆଉ ଥରେ ତାକୁ ଆଟେମ୍ପ୍ଟ ଦିଅନ୍ତୁ
ଆଉ ଥରେ ଅଜିତ ହଁ ଅଜିତ ଆଉ ଥରେ ଅଜିତ ଆଉ ଥରେ ପଚାର
ମୋ ନେଟୱାର୍କ ପ୍ରୋବ୍ଲେମ୍ ଅଛି ଟିକେ 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 ବଡ ବ୍ୟାଟେରୀରେ କୁହ ଟିକେ ଅଜିତ ଟିକେ ବଡ ବ୍ୟାଟେରୀରେ କୁହ ଅଜିତ ମାଇ ଭଏସ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଅଡିଏବଲ୍
ୟେସ୍ ସାର୍
ହଁ ଟିକେ ବଡ ବ୍ୟାଟେରୀରେ କୁହ ଆଉ ଥରେ କ୍ୱେଶ୍ଚନଟା କ'ଣ
ସାର୍ ମାଇ ଭଏସ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଅଡିଏବଲ୍
actually your I think some network problem is going on but you tell in loudly
sir
Okay, Ajit, your question, you otherwise you what give through my WhatsApp number 9439202111. This is my WhatsApp number. Otherwise, you can what give your doubt to my mail also. Immediately, I will sort out. Okay, I think your voice is not coming properly. Bhavani sir, one yes, request. Sir. You off the recording, so we will take a photo actually.
Okay,
just
sir.
We will everybody.